we recently sat down with Daft Punk bass player Nathan East.
Take a look. Chances are you've spent your whole life listening to the music of our next guest.
He's been the bass player for everyone from Beyonce and Whitney Houston to Michael Jackson, Quincy Jones, and most recently, he got lucky with the Grammy-winning duo Daft Punk. Musician Nathan East, welcome to Arise 360.
Thank you so much. It's good to be here.
It's so good to have you here. Are you kidding? Yes. We're the ones who are so lucky.
Yes. Now, we have to talk about that song. And your Grammy performance. I mean, you, Pharrell, Daft Punk, Stevie Wonder, Nile Rodgers, you all had the entire Staples Center on their feet.
You know
what? What was the experience
that
like?
Yoko Ono was there.
When I saw that, I said, you know, when we were rehearsing, I looked down and there was Ringo and Paul McCartney dancing, you know. That was a rehearsal earlier that day. And, I mean, no, it's electrifying. You know, the energy in that place that night was just... you know, everybody was having a great time, and that's what the Grammys are all about.
I was telling a friend of mine, one, I pumped this album the entire summer. And two, the reason I think it was so well received is that everyone felt, it felt futuristic and modern, but it also felt like a throwback to Studio 54. Right.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Well, that was the whole idea about the set on the Grammys. You know, they had the old stone wall with the studio, and this, like, you're in one of the old school studios. And in this, when we were recording, I saw all these retro instruments, and they had tape machines spinning, so it wasn't just like a computerized project, so it was really fun.
Wow.
And you helped Daft Punk walk away with four Grammys this year.
I think, man, I think they even got, they might have gotten five.
Five?
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, did
crazy.
You know you had a hit on your hands, like instant classic when you guys were jamming out in the studio?
You know, you never know that, you know. I mean, if anybody says they do, they don't. But it just, I knew in the studio the funk was jumping out of the speakers.
I love that.
You know.
The funk was jumping out of the speakers, all right.
And when people are dancing in the studio, that's a good indication of something.
Definitely.
Yeah.
What was it like to work with the robots? Do they come in with their masks on? Do you know what they look like?
Right.
Give
you know,
us more. What
I know
do
what they
look like.
I'm sworn to secrecy, though. I couldn't tell you because, you know, I've signed my name in blood.
Really? Are they white? Are they black? Are they green?
I can't tell you.
No, nothing?
What I can tell you is, as a matter of fact, we were taking pictures in the studio, but we couldn't post any of the pictures.
Any of them.
Because... nobody knows what they look like, and if they do, you know, so they literally get off the stage after playing for 45,000 people and walk out in the crowd and walk home with everybody.
And nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
That's crazy. Okay, so we don't want to mess up your sworn secrecy statement, but last week, a photographer snapped a photograph at LAX Airport of the Daft Punk duo. Just tell us if this caption is correct. It says, Daft Punk. There's a caption there above their heads, and they're pointing. Is that picture accurate?
I can't say anything.
Well, I'm not telling you to tell us who they are. We're just saying, is the article legit? That's all.
I can't say anything.
You can't say anything. Okay.
All right. Fair enough.
We have a deal.
It's like, I'm not trying to get in trouble.
No.
Okay. I totally understand. Okay, well, let's talk about your music career. I mean, you, Shannon mentioned it. You've worked with everybody from Barry White to Whitney Houston. My goodness. How did you get into the business, and what was your big break?
Well, it's been busy. My first big break was playing with Barry White when I was 16 years old.
Wow.
And he heard a band of mine that we had called Power in San Diego, and we backed up one of his shows, and he hired the entire band. So the next thing I know, you know, here I am at Madison Square Garden with the Love Unlimited Orchestra and Barry White. You know, we played the Apollo, and it was unbelievable. The orchestra, and he had, you know, everything he touched turned to gold back then, you know, so he had these big hits. And it was my first introduction to, like, really, like, this business. It was amazing.
And after that, the next phone call came from Quincy Jones. It seems like you were an overnight success before you had your license. What was that experience like touring with these major legends?
It's unbelievable, you know. And then when you're on the other end of the phone and Quincy calls you, it's like, really?
Did you think somebody was pranking you?
I always think somebody, who is this?
Right.
But, you know, and it's great, you know, going in the studio with Michael Jackson, and there he is, just a sweetheart of a guy, too, you know. Everybody's great. And on a certain level, they just become all cool people, you know.
Really?
And I remember Whitney Houston, this beautiful girl walking in, first record she ever did, And I remember thinking, you know, she really can sing, but you never know, you know. I said, I hope she makes it, you know. But she was beautiful.
I hope she makes it.
Yeah, I mean, and then that's, I've had that experience with Madonna, you know, before anybody ever heard from her. And so it's just, it's fun to see, you know, the evolution of these artists. Mm-hmm.
And now, after 40-something years, you're finally releasing your own music. Talk to us about that.
I can't
believe
it.
What made you decide to finally share your exclusive talents with the world?
Well, first of all, so many people have asked me over the years, when are you going to do a solo album? Mm-hmm. You know, and it's like, so I'm just so tired of answering that question that I had to make a solo. No, I mean, it's been in my heart, and I've just been so busy, basically, you know, because it took me, I started, you know, this process a year ago, and it's taken about a year to get this thing finished.
Wow. Describe the vibe of your album, and who are some of the stars you collaborated with?
Yeah, we had some good people. I mean, Michael McDonald was one of the first people to say, I'm in, you know.
Wow.
And which, I mean, when you get Michael McDonald to say yes, that's incredible. So he came and did a great version on Van Morrison's song called Moondance, you know. Mm-hmm. And Sarah Bareilles came in and sang a Michael McDonald song for us.
You are kidding.
And she heard the song and said, I got to sing on it.
She had a big night at the Grammys,
She had a big night.
Carole King, my goodness.
Big night and you know, these nominations. And she's great. She's a great writer and singer. And so she's on the record. Then my buddy Stevie Wonder is playing harmonica on the record. And Eric Clapton played guitar for me. I mean, it's just a celebration of music of with my friends.
Well, I know one of your songs is called Daft Funk.
Daft Funk.
So is it all that kind of funky vibe? Does it all have that, like?
Yeah, you know, I mean, after that song, when we were cutting this record, that song was so big you couldn't get it off the radio. So we wrote a song that's kind of an ode to the guys. You know? Michael Thompson, the guitar player, came in with this song we wrote for those guys. And it's just kind of a tip of the hat to them.
Oh, well, that's fantastic. And continued success. We cannot wait to pump your album.
Yes, when and where can we get it?
I predict another Grammy Award-winning
album.
Definitely.
Come on, all right. it's coming out March 25th this year, and it will be on iTunes, and it's available through Yamaha Entertainment Group. So that's the label.
Okay.
And it'll be on my website, their website, iTunes, and everywhere else anybody can go.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks so much.
Pleasure. Success.
Thank you.
All right.
It's fun to be here. You guys party over here.
That's right.
We sure do.
Sports and music. Come on.
We get lucky.
We went all night to get lucky. All right, guys. You're watching Arise Entertainment 360.
See ya.